your leg, dude.
Here we go. This is a new video. New tape. For the continuation of this documentary.
Yeah,
I heard there's a bounty.
Yeah, me too.
I heard the Nazis put a bounty on his head. The guy got punched.
Yeah, no, fuck him.
I don't know if that's true.
Easy and Gina.
Hello.
My first attempt to digitize the other one though was not successful. I was having some issue. Are you recording right now?
I feel like that.
I think you're recording right now. You are.
Must have hit it.
Leave some white space for you to be predominantly yellow onto.
You should do some stuff at the bottom. Just so it's not like such uncharted territory. Like, especially on the right side.
You talking to me or?
Almost looks kind of like a Clifford Still painting, especially on the left side.
Put the gray and the blue, they blend together really nicely.
It's starting to get a little muddy. Okay.
No footage.
This is where it all goes down.
Something we could potentially do is turn it upside down if we want the drips to go the other way. But
I think it's fine as is. I'm also willing to commit to having it, having one side be the top and one side be the bottom.
This one's in progress.
I
John painting brushes.
Gotta clean the brushes when you're done. Otherwise you have a problem on your hands.
Tools and all your skills, and so there's this big
journey just in the magician card where you start like learning and gathering those skills, and then you can become a master, and then you can maybe teach others. But the magician's definitely a creator of their own reality, and someone that like takes raw material, be that like magical energy from all around them, or in a physical sense, like creating something from like raw clay and like making it something real. The magician does that in a magical way too, of like pulling down universal energy and creating a reality. So it's basically an amazing card, one of my fave cards, and I think anyone who really vibes with the magician would be, it's definitely a card for creators, artists, inventors, thinkers, and I think it's a sign just to like keep honing your craft and learning your skills, and when you feel like a master and an expert, then look at how you can share that with others, because that's like why you would go on that journey. Does that make sense?
Yeah, and I like how you mentioned the journey, because it's at the beginning of the whole
the whole
number, the
yeah.
cycle and all that. But yeah, it's, I think when I drew it, it was a time where, you know, I was just unsure of stuff and, you know, the whole ecosystem and balance and all that, and the card kind of told me, like, just keep working on your craft and stuff. But I like how you put into perspective, like, one is, you know, acquiring these tools or skills, and that's going to, you know, you're going to use that, you know, for the rest of the deck or for the rest of the journey.
Exactly. Yeah.
Thanks for your answer.
You're so welcome. Cool. Thanks for asking.
Yeah.
Does anyone else have any thoughts or feelings about the magician they want to share? No pressure.
It did kind of initially blow my mind when I saw all of the elements on the table. So
yeah.
The wand, the cup, the coin, and sword, right? Or mm-hmm. Is he holding the sword?
I think he's holding
a
wand, and there's a sword on the table.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I thought that, of course, that's a great first card because it kind of encapsulates the whole deck.
Yeah, exactly. So the magician has this trickster energy as well as being kind of like just a few seconds after. So it'll be like, what happens?
Oh.
Have you seen this?
No.
It's really cool. You gotta look it up.
Yeah.
It's really cool. I think in the magician and that one, there might be like a monkey that jumps on his back or something like that. Well,
before the dog, and now that the dog is gone, we're kind of like, okay, now we've got to kind of figure out what we mean to each other. So that's me and the woman looking at her falcon. It's me looking at a cat going, okay, it's just you and me now, buddy.
Strikes again. Some crazy shit.
What?
Save a lot. What happened? Yourself?
I don't know. I was doing work in the room, and I heard through the window a voice shout, "Hands up!" And it made me worry. So I looked out the window, and I saw cops pointing guns at men in the car. And now the men are in handcuffs against the car. But I don't know otherwise. It's about like there's like about 10 special, you know, police or undercover cars. So
raining outside, big storm, flash flood warning, and I was coming back home, and there's this bird like drowning, and he was trapped inside a box, and I lifted the box, and inside there was this bird flapping in the water, like drowning in the water, So maybe I'll just wait for him to dry up and then put him behind the steps in the backyard, so he can be outside again and hopefully hold to wait the storm out. We'll see if this guy makes it. So fascinating little creature. Definitely alive, but he's breathing. It seems very frail. Frail little creature. She's being good though.
What? It says the max is like 10. Oh, it's like max 10 a day or something. She could go through one.
But like, should it be separated? Like every couple hours? I don't want to make her sick.
It's a Squishmas quake. What is going on?
Squishmas!
It's testing the quality of our water.
H2O. Okay.
Okay.
Hello! Okay, natural.
Aaron, can you explain what you're doing?
Okay, natural.
We're going to start with the 6 tests for total hardness, chlorine, alkalinity, pH, nitrate, and nitrite.
Nitrite and trite.
This is not a trite test.
We start with this.
A litmus strip.
Fill up the plastic tube.
Mm-hmm.
With water.
Tube.
But this has like a little pill in it.
Yeah, a water filter bag pouch.
It's not the one with this.
This tube full of water. What did you just say, Aaron?
We are citizen scientists right now.
How long do I need to stop water?
Citizen scientists.
This is some serious testing.
We might.
So, Aaron, now that you've tested some of these, do you think we're safe?
I think we're safe in many areas.
Okay, good.
We're about to do the hydrogen sulfide test, which requires us simply to smell.
Smell.
Is everyone noses ready, everyone?
Chris, what's happening in there?
Well, I just put dehydrated tryops eggs into the water, and they're going to supposedly grow into little shrimp-type creatures.
Like this guy.
Like those guys. Tryops food, not for human or pets. Food for tryops only.
extracted. And then when it shows me what it burned onto the disk, everything's there, like all the files and the prize of the game.
Can you guys explain what's happening right now?
A couple years ago, we foolishly misplaced our favorite game, Street Fighter III: Third Strike, on the Dreamcast. And right now we're trying to exploit a design feature that allowed certain Dreamcasts made at a certain time in the production cycle to play burned games. And so we're trying to rip a copy of the game off the internet, put it on a CDR, and play it on the console.
That one either.
It hasn't liked anything.
Any actual games.
Yeah. Any burnt game. It's not played it.
So Chris, explain what happened.
So we were trying to play a burned copy of Street Fighter 3, and we couldn't get it to work. And I just got it to work. Damn it, didn't get you again. Damn it! Well, I'm glad that we're doing this, you guys. Yeah.
I was grateful to get to be a part of a project that is working to intentionally build community and incorporate arts. And I think that's just something that our world really needs more of. More looking out for one another, and more like dinner on the stove waiting for you, and sweet moments like that. And like I remember a lot of nights when I was doing homework in the fall in the living room, just like hearing music from the basement and being like, it kind of sucks that I'm stuck studying right now, but like I still get to like feel the magic that's happening, because it's literally coming up from the floor. And so that felt really special.
Cool, that's really sweet. I love hearing that. Any other thoughts or things, comments you want to, anything else you want to bring up? Or I mean, I think that was really nice.
Yeah, I don't know if there's anything else that's coming up right now. I think I'm just excited to see how it continues to morph and what each of you as individuals, like you as individuals and this like space as a community, how it all continues on your own and its own journeys.
Maybe as like closing words, you want to tell us really quick about where you're headed to now, and like what you know, kind of where you're headed in your path, and you know, you're moving to a different house.
So an opportunity came up to move in with a good friend of mine, and I'm feeling sad to be leaving this magical space, but excited for that next step. I just started grad school at Goddard College, and so it's going to be a lot of studying by myself with books and reading and writing, but with the goal of becoming a licensed therapist, which feels exciting. The new house has lots of porches, and I'm excited for sunlight, like to have sunlight on me as I'm studying. I don't know. I guess I feel like I just arrived, and so I'm still figuring out what's next. Like just last week was week one of grad school, and so I've been looking forward to this moment for so long that I now have to figure out, I don't know what I'm looking forward to next.
Well, thanks for sharing, and yeah, we're really happy to have you stay here for almost a year.
Mm-hmm. It's been great.
Yeah. Thanks, Aaron.
Yay!
discreet, for all intended purposes. They tell me revenge is sweet, and from where they stand, I'm sure it is. But I can't see, I care nothing for the game where beauty goes unrecognized. All I feel is heat and flame, and all I see are dark eyes.
Beyond the night, if I treated you,
so you start with Amish butter and a little brown sugar and put in a little miso and then get it to all caramelize, put in a little coconut jam, and then you put the eggplant in, Chinese eggplant, and then you cook it, and then you top it with a little pastry crust, a little pepper say.
Yeah.
So,
like,
tongue
will, like, stick out
of the place.
I know.
He literally just wants snuggles, that's it.
I like how Chili is. He's part Chihuahua, right?
Yeah, he's actually all Chihuahua. He's a long-haired Chihuahua. More like aggressive.
They kind of hate you until they love you.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Like until they deem you worthy.
Until you've ignored them, or until you've ignored them enough that they just can't handle it.
Exactly.
We were joking how the bed bug inspecting dog would be a Chihuahua.
We gotta keep it rolling.
Come if on, they yeah. were small though, I. All I know is I went into work with.
Lana down right here.
What do you mean, just like kind of scrape it?
He's spreading the ink out.
Thank you.
Hey, so we're in the studio with Ami, who's a friend who's visiting, working, making prints in the studio. Ami, do you want to explain what you're about to do?
Yeah. So what we got here is we got a lino cut block, and what we're about to do is ink it up, put some ink on here, gonna lay the paper on top, and rub it down so we get some pressure the block, and then once we pull it up, we should have a cool image going on. So let's see what happens.
So you're putting some pressure now?
Yeah, so we're just putting pressure on top of the paper. So we laid the paper right on top of the lino cut, and now we're just rubbing it on. So let's see this guy. All right, so we're gonna need some more ink on this one because it's not looking too dark, but kind of get a feel for it. Some more ink on this one. One turned out good, nice and dark. Perfect.
New one. Is this the best one, Ami?
Yeah, we got one. This is the good one.
Nice.
Yeah.
Sweet.
The actual tips. Oh yeah. Yeah, baby. Who's close what? Enough?
Not too close.
Who's close? Oh. Oh yeah. Tell me about your process.
Often I start with a lot of transparent layers, so I can get like different textures and stuff like that, and then I, at least with this recent body of work, then I kind of cut in and do these other shapes over all these layers. I just try to look for different shapes and compositions and color combinations.
Color combis.
Yeah.
Then I guess what I'm doing. Zooming like a bitch. No zoom, right?
No zoom.
There we go. Did you get Ami already?
Yes. Yeah, we got the whole process earlier.
Everything looks like so dark through this little camera peek hole. So.
You still filming?
No.
Session. My worry is in bullshit.
Yeah, let's see the tricks.
I have a weird body trick. Let's see it.
Okay.
Oh.
Whoa.
Back in from France last night.
So glad.
This is my first day back in Baltimore after a two-month-and-a-half hiatus.
And what day is it?
Today's Friday.
Of what year?
2019.
And what is the date?
It's the 11th of January.
There you go.
Yeah. So yeah, pretty crazy. And I'm about to go on a two-week residency in North Carolina. It's my first residency, first ceramics, so I'm really excited.
Yeah.
Mary, what's the scoop?
I thought we did the scoop already.
We're reliving
or
the moment.
Or did we?
I worked with kids today, and I'm happy to have Yone back and Chris back and Jeremy with everyone.
Nice.
What's good? It's your boy, Phil.
What's up, Phil?
Bless you.
Thank you.
Back from romance land and trying to get into dance land. We're here in the in-between. And
Right. Yeah,
we've been grubbing. It's good.
All
just,
right.
You know.
Just vibing.
All right.
Sounds good.
Hey, hello.
What's up, Katie?
I spent the day spray painting and doing nail polish stuff, so I lost lots of brain cells, but just making art.
Hey, Cameron.
What's up, Anne?
Cameron Bang.
That's me.
We've just finished this big plate of food.
Wow.
This one's yours, but everyone else's had a similarly large portion of delicious yums. There's hot heat. There's nutritional dust, and there's wilty cabbage. If you choose to add to all these things,
isn't it nutritional stardust? Yeah.
Okay. I cooked on a food truck that I also drove through the city, and we sold out of crab cakes.
Nice.
What about you?
For myself, I just returned from a long journey in Virginia with multiple chapters, and taking care of my mom,
and working on jiu-jitsu, working on my income, which is low.
I think a lot of us feel that.
It's the start of the year, so
yeah,
it only goes up.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Any words you want to share with your future self?
Make sure the tape gets digitized again.
Nice.
Yeah. Come on.
All right. And there's also going to be a scene coming up in the tape that is shot previously to this.
Or was it?
Or was it?
We're gonna go back in time.
Yeah, which is, in my knowledge, the first time that's happened in this whole project. So.
Wow. 2019, the year for firsts.
Yeah. Yes. last year the teens, baby.
Man, what a crew!
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Cheers to that. Let the grapes fall where they may.
Yeah.
Woo!
And Anne is ready to stay up until 3 a.m. with me.
Watching Star Trek?
That's
yeah,
really
new
cute.
Star Trek comes out next week. But my true favorite is
Man,
out tonight.
It's like 2:45. You better hurry up and eat. Wait.
Chris, I'm going to get a picture of you. Yep, gotcha.
Let me get one too, actually.
You got me, yo.
9:30.
So it's like 3 in the morning.
It's like 3 in the morning.
Are you on Instagram, Chris?
I'm proud of you being.
You know, we talked about this and not yet, but a lot of people are like, you should join.
Well, when you get there, I'll send this to you.
All right, dude.
Or you can text it to him.
Oh, it's the wrong way.
That sounds good.
I could text.
Or you can send it to Rite Aid and pick it up at 24-hour total.
Cyborg man.
Cyborg the gargoyle.
Oh, that's good.
That's good. That's definitely an Instagram only thing.
Very good. Like snow crash in our own kitchen here. Yo, tippy tappy. VNA, I can't see your feet over here, man.
Yes. Get that river dance down, baby. Get that river dance down, baby.
Proud of you. And hump them dramatically.
Stop it! I don't
want to. So you do.
VNA?
Yeah?
Can we make some hot cocoa sometime?
You mean a hot cookie
dough? I mean a hot cocoa.
This is the long take of...
What about it?
What?
You got...
Hello. Whatever is it that you're doing over there, young man?
Cooking meat.
What sort of meat does thou cook, young man?
Beef.
Beef. Ah, yes. Beef.
Beef.
Beef. You've got great pecs, young man.
Thank you.
Very strong looking. Sir? Baltimore Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu!
Did you get that?
Nope. Try it. Just one. You don't have to face it. Just face the window and try. Go ahead. Let's see it. Let's hear it. You're facing away. You can do it.
You have to do it first.
It's your turn. Quickly. Wait, do it one more time really loud. Go, come on. You just did it. I heard it. You can go off camera. I'll focus on the soap.
Making there?
Some mushrooms and a sirloin steak and kale salad for dinner after jujitsu.
Nice.
Mimi hasn't had her meat yet. She's very antsy. And she wants the meat. She'll do anything for the meat.
That's your thing.
Yeah, that's my one. Yeah, I think I maybe missed it for like 3 months. Mm. Like it doesn't smell recognizably like meat. Yeah.
Chris cooking onions. Another Chris lives here. Chris, do you want to briefly introduce yourself and say who you are and what you do?
I mean, I'm not great at briefly doing anything that involve words coming from my face, but I will do my best. I'm devastated first and most importantly that the only cooking that might be documented of me right now is like easily my weakest skill set, which is just general knife skills. I blame being left-handed, maybe, but I blame it for a lot of things, but also I've developed a weird bias against right-handed people that I constantly have to consciously check because most of my favorite people are, because most people are, which is all to say that I am a poet and screenwriter and sometimes like vegan home cook chef type deal. I'm gonna just stop.
And pizza one.
Yeah, you gotta show the crosshatch cornbread over there.
Oh, yeah.
He's on it. The eyes are really kind of creepy.
It's.
Somebody needs to make a comment at the exact perfect time.
I envision like the triangular parts going down like this?
Alright, baby.
The academy starts now.
Oh yeah.
Best be careful.
There should be a shot.
Alright. That's beautiful.
Holy cow, V&A.
They're building a road or something?
Yeah, they are doing some kind of pavement, so it could be a road to connect the alley to Charles, or maybe a parking lot. And then it's been an empty lot for a long time, used to be a garden. And there's this guy, Earl, over the years who works on cars out there. And there's a sign that says mechanic on duty 24/7, 202-288-2957, Earl. And he is back in there. He's been living there maybe in this hut, and he's been cleaning up the lot. The community garden, maybe, or something? I don't know. It was just
an empty lot.
Oh, empty lot, snowy day, and roommates used to park back there. And then one day on the snowy day, they got towed. They dumped it.
Bit by bit, the story gets told.
I like that. Okay, go ahead. You start.
Well, I was thinking that you would start.
It was your idea.
Right, and in my idea, you start.
Fine. Once upon a time, there was a big forest, and it was just about sunset. And there was Mama Squirrel.
There was a little baby squirrel coming home from a busy day. Mm-hmm. Hey, Mom. What's up? What you been doing?
Mostly collecting nuts for dinner.
Oh, yeah. Well, I read they had been traveling through all the doors and windows and portals to everywhere they could imagine, and they traveled everywhere all across the infinite dimensions of imagination, except for one door, which happened to be the door that they came in. So they were a little nervous about that.
I can't see your imaginary friends, and you can't see mine. At least I think you can't.
Yeah, you're right. And I don't know. Well, how about we create a collab imaginary friend?
What's a collab imaginary friend?
Well, you know, we can design one together. I'll say a little part, and you say a little part, and then I say a little part, and then bit by bit, our imaginary friend gets built.
I like that.
All right, great. Well, let's see. I think I want it to be like a bird. Yeah, that's nice and symbolic.
And I like fire.
Yeah, and one big eye, because, you know, it's going to go through that door, and I think there's a singularity on the other side, and it needs a single eye to perceive that correctly.
Feel, feel, feel.
Sadness, anger, also, you know, hope, belief, you know. I feel like I'm saying hi to God right now.
Wow.
And that's not an overstatement, because
I wish I could experience the sun for the first time.
Yeah, the truth is, you know, this, yeah. I think I have to dance too.
Thank you.
bird we have going on here. This is a Pope John Holiday production. Sponsored by butter.
By Bunyan's butter biscuits.
We're gonna make some curry. Just like in India.
Sean, how does it feel to be back here visiting?
Feels great. Let's get the curry going in there.
Yeah, we need these.
Not yet.
What are you doing, Caleb?
Ooh. Dancing.
Excellent dancing, Caleb.
Oh, what is going on over there?
In your mouth?
Ooh. That looks like something.
I think it works.
Ooh.
Can you take a chunk and put it on right now?
No. That's Miles right there. He's a nasty boy. Anne is cavorting with her body.
Let her rip.
We now bring you Tush Cam 2019. Everybody be quiet.
Uh-oh, Tush Cam's getting a little more rigid.
Ooh, Tush Cam activated.
Crank it.
Crank it.
Open that can.
I do declare.
You hungry?
Yum, 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 yum.
Thank you.
dog talk out fun, and we're going to show you guys that can dish it out and guys that can take it. I call it the chain reaction. You ready? Come on, let's go.
Oh, underground.
Oh, on the ground, I sing.